Good morning, all of you, and it's such a pleasure to be here in front of you, you know, having this session here. Like our MC said, this is pretty much the very first pure gift card conclave that we are having probably in the region. And, you know, to be very honest, we are a little anxious. So how this is going to pan out, and thank you all for really coming over here, and, you know, your presence is really what is making this occasion, you know, special for us, and really looking forward to a you know, fabulous morning here with all of you around. So we've been doing the sessions in India for some years now, and you know, one of the main purposes of this has always been to actually get people who are practitioners or the users of the gift cards, could be the merchants who are issuing, could be the distributors who are in the process of selling it, could be the online portals who are actually distributing it in some sense. Get all the ecosystem players to come together, share their best practices and see what they have done well. So it's all about the category. That is the intent of this. And, you know, so I'm not used to speaking in these events. I'm sorry, but I'm not that good of a speaker, you know, on the stage, right? So, but this time around, we thought it's important since the category is pretty nascent here. We're trying to pull this out. Thought we'd take a few, you know, maybe around 20, 30 minutes to actually walk you through in terms of what all things we have done in the Indian market and what we've learned from there. It's not about Qwikcilver, it's about the category, and we wanted to kind of see how many of those would probably be relevant in this market, and more importantly, how those can be adopted into, you know, and more as a way to kind of, you know, motivate the ecosystem here to see what we can do to build out this category to make life simpler for, you know, so many of us. That's the whole intent behind it. So please bear with me. So it's a presentation I'm going to go through. And hopefully from next year, we don't have to do this. And probably many of you would be here talking about the success stories that you have had in this category. So I have a timer here. So somewhere I do get carried away talking about what has happened. So I'll make sure I stick to this.
Gifting. There's something beautiful and pure in that one moment when someone shares joy with another. But finding the perfect gift for someone isn't easy, whether it's for the consumer, employee or channel partner. Thankfully, with a gift card, that process is now effortless and joyful. So what really is a gift card? A gift card is a gateway to a world of perfect gifts. A gift card empowers the receiver the freedom to choose the perfect gift. And what if your brand could become a seamless part of this special moment of celebration? You now can. With the single most preferred gifting choice in markets, including the US. We are talking about the next generation of physical gift cards and digital e-gift cards. And that's where we come in. Say hello to Qwikcilver, the world's first and only end-to-end gift card solutions provider, right from gift card procurement to distribution. The pioneer of the gift card revolution in India, with a presence across the globe. With over 12,000 plus physical points of sale across 600 plus cities. Qwikcilver powers and manages gift card systems for thousands of leading consumer brands. And is the most trusted choice in corporate gifting for over 600 plus corporates. Gift cards are our core business. We launched Woohoo, India's most powerful gift card distribution platform. The Woohoo app combines the joy of the gift card with the ease of the mobile, making it the preferred destination for consumers. Qwikcilver is the only complete end-to-end gift card solution enabler with a future-ready SaaS platform. Qwikcilver's state-of-the-art platform is a result of extensive R&D and best-in-class infrastructure investment that incorporates social media, digital suite, omni-channel wallets, personalized gift cards and group gifting, so that as your business grows, so does the way you gift. We enable real-time, cross-border, multi-currency transactions that work across time zones. So wherever in the world your consumer accesses your brand, you access it in real-time. As a one-stop partner, Qwikcilver brings you its entire roster of offerings that includes business process services, secure banking standards, and it makes absolute sense for your consumer too, because it lets them take the guessing out of gifting. As a brand, a gift card is a complete win-win scenario for you, providing unlimited ways in which we can add value and engagement to your brand consumer connect. It's simple, it's efficient, its power like no other. Just power your brand with Qwikcilver and watch as the joy of gifting rubs off on your brand and empowers your business to connect with your consumer like never before.
Thank you for that, and so Pratap will be happy now we played a Qwikcilver marketing presentation on this, and I'm sure this is an opportunity for us also to showcase what all we can do, right? So going back into the category, so one of the things that we have been tracking is the growth of these categories across various geographies, right? As we all know, US has been the trendsetter here. Like what you have seen in the slides, it's almost like a $175 billion market, pure gift card market in the US. And the data shows about almost all 28% of all gifting is through gift cards in the US, right? So that's become the gold standard for many of us to try and see what we can do to get there. And the projection for, if you look at, the next 5 years, very clearly APAC is going to be the fastest growing market. And that's the opportunity we're all sitting on here, right? And we expect it to become almost like 29% of the global market opportunity for gift cards. And this is something that we have repeatedly seen in the studies that we have been undertaking, right? And the other interesting aspect is, if you look at the US gift card market, obviously even today it's like almost 85% is dominated by physical cards, right? And probably 10 to 15% range is digital cards. Whereas we are seeing in these markets it's completely different. Especially in India, we almost see about 80% of all gift cards is digital. And we see the same trend picking up here. We see there's so much more opportunity to digitize, right? So these are some of the variations we're seeing. And what we look at globally too, over the next 5 years, the whole equation is going to shift. It's going to be, the growth is going to be driven largely by digital gift cards as against physical gift cards, and it makes so much more sense from the overall ecosystem perspective, right? So here's a big opportunity we are all sitting on in this region. Right, and we are probably going to be defining this whole category over the next 5 years, and that's really the opportunity that we can all, kind of be part of this ecosystem. Yeah. A quick insight on what has happened in India. So the intent of putting it here is to, kind of see what's the kind of growth we have seen over the years, and maybe also talk you through some of the aspects that drove this growth, and then see how much of it actually is going to be relevant, what can be adapted to this market, right? So over the last 7 years, we've seen about, over the 5 years, 7x growth is we've seen in this category. Today, we're clocking a run rate of almost like about 2 billion plus in terms of value, right? And if you look at 5 years back, and the kind of growth we have seen has been tremendous, right? And we're doing almost like 400 million cards right now, our run rate in terms of number of cards that we manage. And this has been a massive growth, from where we started to where we are. We have almost like about 200 plus leading brands. Across, you name the category, you would have a gift card for that category. Be it department stores, be it online, be it hospitality, several other services. So it's a no-brainer, right, for any of these merchants, quote-unquote, irrespective of the category, to have their own gift card. Because ultimately, it's their currency. Somebody else is buying their currency, telling them to keep their prepaid money with them, and say it'll be used in future. Why not? Of course, it actually makes a lot of sense to every single merchant out there to have a gift card program. And that's really what we have been seeing too. And this is another unique aspect we saw in India, and we're seeing the same pattern in these regions too, is the gift card purchase is largely dominated by B2B purchases. That could be for the reward programs as in could be employee rewards, could be channel promotions, could be consumer promotions, all kinds of rewards. And the adoption of gift cards in these, especially the digital gift cards, has been actually phenomenal, right? In fact, I would say the B2B category has been the one who's been, driving the growth in India, and especially of the digital gift cards. And like I said, this could be something we would actually see in these markets too. So when we started, I would say that, it's like about, it took us a decade in India, to be very honest, to get to the stage where we are in. We're hoping that we will do it much more faster here, thanks to all the ecosystem already established. It was very much like in Singapore, right? It was all paper vouchers. There was very little technology behind it. It was all paper vouchers. Most retail, and no retailer would ever say, I don't have a gift voucher. You walk in, either they'll give you a paper voucher, or they will print on the letterhead. It's like an IOU, right? Yeah, you can exchange this letter I'm giving you for a purchase at any of my stores, right? They would never say, I don't have a gift voucher. That's how it used to be, right? And you know all the challenges of the paper vouchers. They're so inefficient operationally. The security is a challenge. So we had to do a lot of, pinpointing the initial days, explaining to the benefits of technology behind it. So I do see some of the markets that we are in today are like what India would have been maybe about 10 years back. And it took us literally almost like 3 years to get the first big major launch happen there. And I think it's very different here. I think this 10 years can be easily crunched to 3 years in a country like this, in the entire market, right? Because of the presence of the ecosystem, because of the technology, the infrastructure that's available, which is very different from what it was maybe 10 years back in India, right? And retail itself is so much more advanced here, so it makes it so much more easier to get a category of this nature into the market, right? So we have to do a lot of, initial selling, evangelizing, create the entire market, so that was a while, right? But the benefits are very obvious. You know, what you do with the paper voucher watch, right now you're doing with a digital gift card which can be delivered on SMS, email, can be added to your wallet. I mean, life is so much more simpler, seamless. So that's where we started off. And once we started working with the merchants to create their gift cards, right, one of the biggest challenges was that, our e-commerce was growing in India. Right? How do you make these gift cards available online? And many of the traditional brick and mortar merchants did not have their online presence at that point in time. So what we really had to do was create what we call as microsites for each of these merchants. You know, so in effect, probably we were the first guys to get them onto an e-commerce platform to start selling gift cards online, right? And we were managing all the stores for pretty much most of the merchants very quickly. And that was another one which changed the trajectory for them, right? Now people were able to access these gift cards much more easier. Corporates were able to buy bulk gift cards, you know, go online and buy it, rather than having to reach out to a corporate sales team. So many of the traditional methods of purchasing gift cards started changing and they were kind of becoming online, right? So there are several trends which are adding on to this. One was physical cards getting, you know, created. Now, we actually leapfrogged. When we moved from paper voucher, we initially had a phase where we were doing physical cards. But very quickly, we realized physical cards are not the way to go, right? And we pretty much leapfrogged it to get onto the digital cards. So, once we launched in a matter of 3-4 years, most of our brick and mortar retailers were launching digital cards. You know, most of them were accepting it at the stores. Thanks to the microsites that we had, they were able to sell it online, even if they didn't have an e-commerce store. Because we were making them sell their gift cards online. You know, and this was probably their first foray into the entire online space, right? And that kind of, again, drove this whole market, you know, forward, right? The other big trend that happened was emergence of people like Flipkart, Snapdeal, and subsequently Amazon, right? So one of the challenges in India, we see such a vast country out there, you have different types of cities, you have tier 1 city, tier 2 cities, tier 3 cities, you know. And many of the traditional brick and mortar retailers did not have presence across all these tiers. They are probably dominant position in tier 1. Maybe some of them may have a few stores in tier 2, right? Otherwise, the coverage wasn't there. And many of them, again, weren't selling their products online. They didn't have an e-commerce store. And like I said, gift cards probably were their first e-commerce presence, right? They didn't have an e-commerce store. So if I go to, let's say, a corporate who want to run, let's say, a channel rewards program. Now, we have a challenge of a product market fit. If you were to give them a gift card of a retailer who is present only in tier 1 city, how will they scale across the country? There was always a problem, right? So, the moment the online retailers came on, right, that gap immediately got bridged. Now, you could have people sitting in tier 1, tier 2 cities getting gift cards of, let's say, a Flipkart or an Amazon or a Snapdeal and be able to order online and get it delivered. Right, that again opened up several avenues for us from an overall, you know, market adoption perspective. And I think many of those are already crossed here. E-commerce is already thriving and you have presence of large players here. So we have already crossed all those hurdles. Whereas in India, we had to go through the path, you know, do for the physical cards, take away the vouchers, get to physical cards, get them to digital cards, create online stores, and the moment the e-commerce players came in, get their gift cards, and then, you know, make it available for the corporates. It was a pretty long journey out there, right, to get to this stage. Whereas here, I feel we actually crossed many of those and, you know, leapfrog multiple levels, you know, into the market itself, right? The other one was about how do you get this to the consumers. I would say Amazon possibly, and to a certain extent, Flipkart and some of the online travel portals like Make My Trip and Clip have been very successful in creating the consumer adoption of this category. Right? While it's still smaller compared to the B2B, and one of the things they did was how do you make this whole gifting experience highly personalized? So I'm not sure how many of you have seen, let's say, an Amazon store in India, the Amazon.in. You'd see the kind of options they would have provided in, be it in terms of packaging, be it in terms of designs, occasion-based, theme-based. You know, it's so flexible. The catalog is so wide, right? The gift card itself is a, you know, a comprehensive catalog that they have. And actually that, in some sense, drove the whole adoption on the consumer side. Today, Amazon is probably the trendsetter from getting gift cards in the hands of the consumer, and now many of the brands have started adopting those techniques, right? So this is another thing that we have seen working very nicely, both digital and physical. So whether digital, the kind of designs and templates and stuff that you have, the physical, the kind of packaging, you know, you have gift cards that come in tin boxes, you have gift cards that are occasion-specific, greeting cards attached to it. You've got so many varieties of it that they have created around it. The other one was the omni-channel nature, right? So we had now merchants who had brick-and-mortar stores, they had an online presence, primarily through gift cards, to buy a gift card. Now, many of them started creating their online stores also. So what it really meant was suddenly it's opened up an opportunity to make the gift cards truly an omni-channel product. How can I come into the store and spend the gift card partly? How can I go online and use the same card, spend the balances, right? How can I use a mobile app and spend the remaining balance? So it became a true currency container for the merchants where it actually can be used across these various touch points. And that meant that the technology power has to be so much more significant, and you know, we could logically take them to an omni-channel solution from a specific channel solution, right? And you know, almost all the retailers today in India have their online presence, and all their gift cards, be it physical card or the digital card, is completely omni-channel today. That's another big difference we saw. And when we pay omni-channel, again the acceptance increased because you know, people again sitting in tier 2 city now could order also from a lifestyle stores. So earlier, if I look at, let's say, a lifestyle gift card, it was limited to a tier 1. Now when they had their online presence, when these gift cards became omni-channel, now that barrier went away. Now as a product, now they could reach to the entire country from what they were earlier being restricted to some of the tier 1 cities. This is occasion-based has actually worked very well, you know, especially in the online channels. So when we create this microsites or they have it in their own stores, you would see almost through the year, there is always a campaign and promotion specifically running with gift cards and which are occasion-specific. And India, I'm sure many of you know, is a country where there are festivals and events happening literally throughout the year. It's either a countrywide festival or regional. You'd see both. Right, and there's a lot of attention given by the merchants, because now you'll find that one of the best practices we have seen is all the merchants who have been successful in this category, they have actually business teams which own this entirely. So they treat it as a category. In fact, for many of them, if you were to treat it like an SKU equivalent, probably this is the largest selling SKU for them, you know, compared to anything else, right? And probably it's the fastest growing also. So that's what they view it as, and you know, that's the kind of attention they give. And wherever people have that kind of an attention from a retailer side, I think we have seen those programs to be extremely successful. So we want people to look at the strategic part of their overall business, something which drives, like I said, probably the largest SKU that they have, you know, and it is really like a category by itself. And that's the kind of focus people drive to this, right? These are some of the other very interesting things that we, you know, kind of have our merchants take up and do is, for example, variable denominations, you know, occasion-based themes, audio messages. So how can I put an audio message into my gifting? How can that be part of my gifting experience, right? All those have become part of today, the gifting ecosystem where people use gift cards. See, how often can you send a digital gift instantaneously to somebody? If you suddenly remember somebody's birthday, how many options do you have to send them a personalized, you know, gift, right? Here is a gift card that you can actually send them instantaneously with your own personalized message attached to it. Maybe it could be an audio, video, whatever you would want. Send it to them and they can instantaneously, as soon as they receive it, use the gift at the store. So it is literally, you are actually, you know, digitally gifting them, which they can use immediately to buy whatever they want. It's very powerful, and there are very few products that you can actually today kind of create that kind of an emotional attachment from a gifting aspect. Everything else means your logistics over it, right? Group gifting was another very interesting concept we launched, you know, which is again targeted largely towards corporate, right? Where people pull and do a gifting together, right? And this is another thing which we find our corporate customers find very interesting and started adopting it, right? Various gift cards, right? So if you look at it, you have gift card purchases broadly will be into two buckets. There are consumers and we have corporate buyers, right? From a consumer's perspective, it's all about emotion. It's all about, I want to give now, how do I give it, right? How can I make the whole process seamless, easy? How can I have it at several different touch points? I can go to the merchant side, you know, I can go to, it's another very interesting thing is that third-party gift cards, right? So I'm sure many of you are aware in the US, third-party gift card retailing is a big opportunity, right? You have gift stands that are sitting at various retail stores where you could walk in, pick up a gift card and things like that, right? So in India, one of the things we've seen is, like I said, digital being more popular, we have now created those gift card stores almost in all consumer digital destinations. So what I mean is, Amazon has its own gift card which we power, right? In addition, we have created a gift card store on Amazon through which they sell third-party gift cards. So you could actually walk in and buy a department store gift card out of Amazon. You could purchase, you know, any of the services. You could buy a Taj Experiences, you know, gift card from Amazon, right? And this is just not Amazon. We have now pretty much all the major digital stores, online stores, wanting to create gift cards as a category. Because they feel that creates a lot more attachment with their consumers. And being digital, it's so much more easier to manage. And of course, technically, we take care of it. So today, you have Amazon, we have PhonePe, which is part of Flipkart. We have Paytm, you know, which has got its own gift card store. Samsung Pay, PayPal. You name it, you have pretty much all the online destinations having a gift card store, which is actually thriving in some sense, probably delivering more margins than their other categories. So a significant focus from all these merchants, you know, in terms of creating this category. And that's also been another push they have been doing from an online to offline. So what happens is, you go to a Paytm and buy a brick and mortar gift card from there. What you're effectively achieving is actually taking the consumer who's going online and getting the business to the offline merchant. And this is another thing which we've seen, you know, almost like year on year, it's growing almost like 125%. Just this online digital category alone for us, okay, with the presence across all these major retailers. And that's another opportunity that we are seeing in this market, right? But when you situate the B2B side, we look at the corporate gifting into three buckets. I'm sure that's how most countries also look at it, right? Is one is rewards, which are employee rewards. So how can I reward my employee? Good recognitions, could be, you know, their annual rewards and stuff like that. So there's an employee rewards. Then you would have the channel rewards, right? So I have a distributor, I have my, you know, retailer, stockist, you know, how do I reward them, right? That becomes your channel rewards, and you have your consumer promotions. So I buy a washing machine, how can I give a reward to them, right? So traditionally, you know, in India at least, many of these gifting programs used to be, you know, merchandise driven. What I mean is that, let's say I'm running a channel reward program, I would, you know, keep giving reward points to my channel partners, and then send them a catalog. So if you have 10,000 points, you'll be eligible for, let's say, a cell phone. If you have 20,000 points, I can get you a washing machine. And there's been so much of a pain in terms of the logistics overhead. You know, people used to keep calling, say, I have too many points, you have to validate it, somebody will ship it, it will not reach them, you know. It was all a painful process, right? And some of them did try to, you know, get gift vouchers there, which is actually becoming reasonably popular, right? Again, the same logistics headaches, remind. Because I have to ship the voucher, it takes a bunch of days. These vouchers are currency, cash sitting with the distributors. You buy these vouchers from the merchants and you have them with you. You have real currency notes with you. Now, how do you safeguard them? And when you ship it, you know, many of them didn't have a mechanism to say if it is lost in transit, how do you block it? And, you know, the person receiving it,
he could very well say, take the cover and say, I have no voucher in it. You could neither prove or disprove that. You know, so there's too much of headache with those paper, you know, process around it, especially when you didn't have a technology behind it, right? So now everything is seamless, right? The same channel partner, he's got his reward points. All that he does is he sends an SMS from his registered mobile number saying, I would like to burn my this one, say, you know, for Amazon, 10,000 rupees. In real time, his points are deducted. A 10,000 rupees Amazon gift card is generated and delivered to him on his mobile, which he can immediately use. So look at the kind of efficiency this whole digital gift card has brought into the market. It's cut out this whole inefficient process. The security aspects is all managed. You don't have to worry about logistics, you know. And that's a sea change in this whole B2B gifting. And that's the reason why this as a category has been growing tremendously for us. And we've seen almost, you know, I can probably have maybe 20, 25 slides, or just restrict to a few slides here, is every category of a corporate has started embracing gift cards as a means to manage rewards, right? So let's say, for example, banks. So banks, how they reward their consumers? You have bank credit card, debit card catalogs. You keep early credit card reward points. What do you use it for, right? So today, gift card based gifting for your burning of your credit card reward points is fuel. Almost every bank has their own gift card catalog that they put up, which has all the various merchants' gift cards in it. The merchants are very happy because the business ultimately is getting driven to them. And the banks are very happy. There's no operational overhead. You know, everything is seamless. There is no cost of shipping and all those are cut out, right? So it's been a sea change there, right? Promotions. Now, people are the banks have started using gift cards as a very easy way to run various promotions. So you go open a savings bank account, instantly get a digital gift card. You know, you kind of upload your KYC. You know, for every different behavior of the consumer, they are able to instantly reward them, right? And they are also able to run promotions with their merchant partners. So you get your credit card bill, they say, you know what, you spent so much, you know, you're eligible for a, say, a Titan watch. Titan is the largest watch brand. Just send an SMS, you instantly get the Titan voucher. And you actually, in the Titan store, you can send this SMS, get this voucher, show it to the cashier, redeemed. So almost every bank, in whatever ways they can, they've started embracing, you know, gift card as a way to drive, you know, promotions, for consumer rewards, and just this banks, I took as an example because that's one of the largest spenders in this, right? But this, like I said, applies to every different category. FMCG brands, so today we work with almost all the leading FMCG brands in India, right, for their channel rewards. And like I said, traditionally it was all being done by merchandise. All of them, they give out reward points, all their channel partners come to a customized microsite that we create for the corporates. They come there, burn their reward points, instantly get whatever gift cards they would like, and go use it. It's completely self-served. There's no need for anybody sitting and waiting for a call, no need to handle any shipping, right? And they have enough choices to spend it rather than the FMCG brand deciding, I will give them an LG washing machine, a Samsung phone. I mean, how many Samsung phones they can carry with them around the LG washing machine? They will keep on changing it, right? Because here it's left to them, they decide what they want. And naturally it's increased their, you know, the comfort content quotient on that. And this is, like I said, applies to every single type of corporate. You know, today we're finding it, you know, extremely popular. Now we work with several, wouldn't believe, paints, Asian paints, you know, they're actually now moving all their promotion campaigns to gift card based. Okay, cement companies. So they have their channel partners, you know, they're all onto the gift card. So it's kind of category. So the beauty of this is that rewards program also we've seen is category agnostic. And the gift card is a means to reward. It's again a category agnostic. And one is having merchant gift cards. Now we are having, let's say, you know, Hyundai or a Honda, you know, their gift cards coming into play. So now we are creating gift cards for some of these automobile companies. And people are burning their reward points for, let's say, a gift card of a specific, you know, say Honda gift card, and they go use it for purchasing cars. So you're actually seeing the spend values going significantly higher. You have gift cards which can actually be for, let's say, $5, $10 gift cards. Chenu, we've seen gift cards, you know, like a car gift card and stuff, you know. And we're seeing this whole range depending on the nature of reward programs that's being run. Right? Jewelry is another extremely popular category from a, you know, gift cards perspective that we've seen. So what we have kind of realized is gift cards are actually category agnostic, be it from a merchant side or from a, you know, buyer side. It's just a means to connect the two. You know, it's a fantastic tool to drive, you know, footfall, new customer acquisitions to any kind of a merchant. And it just makes the process so seamless. And it's also digital that, you know, you'll take away all the overheads. So what it really means is the opportunity that we're all sitting on is phenomenal. Literally, you know, every single category we could actually get onto the gift card. I already spoke to you about this, so let me just skip through this, right? You know, one other thing that we have been doing, you know, something which we started is that it's one of the category building, right? So now almost all merchants have realized the power of this category. And like I said, the B2B side of it is growing very nicely. And now people want to actually kind of get what can we do to, you know, activate the B2C side. So one of the initiatives is we actually brought in the merchants in the country together, okay, and created this whole concept of a gifting carnival. So now we actually have now started this carnival, which will lead on, let's say, till the festival season. You would find almost all our partners participating in this carnival. Wherever consumers see, they start seeing gift cards as a means to gift. They become part of this gifting carnival. There are offers, promotions, you know, around it. So we're saying gift card itself is a category of gifting, and why can't the entire players in the ecosystem come together to build it? Because everybody is going to benefit out of it. And this is a new initiative, you know, we are looking at how this is going to pan out, you know. And the nice thing is, almost all merchants, right, they may be competing out there. Okay, you would find a Shopper Stop or a Myntra or a Flipkart or Amazon, they are competing. But when it came to this event as a gifting carnival theme, all of them are participating with this. So this is a complete category building activity, and we'll have to wait and see how the results are, but so far actually it's been very encouraging. And because there are several guys who have been actually participating in this, bringing in special offers and stuff, and they have been promoting it to their database. So every merchant is promoting it to saying, hey, here's a gifting carnival, why don't you use gift cards for your gifting, these are the offers. So we have merchants participating, we have channels which are selling third-party cards and their own cards participating. So the entire ecosystem is part of this whole event. It's really what's happening there, right? So let me just pause here for a minute, right? So the intent of this, I mean, I can keep talking like this because 10 years is a very long time from where we started to where we are today. And there's so many trends that have affected us, right? Like I said, right from taking the physical vouchers, getting them into cards with technology, getting digital cards, getting merchants online to sell these cards, getting the B2B channel activated, getting the efficiencies there, you know? I mean, it's been a full journey for us, right? And it's been a wonderful journey over the decade in creating this, right? But we really believe with our experience there in the market, and of course the ecosystem already so vibrant here, and what have we achieved there in 10 years? We're saying we can actually get to that point in 3 years here. That's how we are viewing it. And with all your support, I think we can actually create such an ecosystem. And this is a quick, on the kind of products that we have evolved over these years, right? So let's say, for example, when we look at gift cards, right? So generally, it's all about gifting, B2B gifting, I talked about all those, right? Now you see merchants using gift cards as their currency surrogate, right? So what it means is that when I have to give cashback, it is actually in the form of gift cards. When I have to, you know, kind of get a consumer who is doing a return, so it's like a store credits. Many of the Indian retailers to give it out as store credits. Now all those becoming gift cards. Or even the online guys all becoming gift cards, right? So you would find people now using gift cards for pretty much wherever they feel their currency needs to be given, it is a gift card today, right? And in some sense, the way they look at it, I am in some sense gifting my consumer. It could be me paying and gifting them. or them buying doesn't matter. I am getting them. And that also meant that every merchant needed to have their way. So I am as a consumer, I am using 10 different gift cards of a merchant. Now, where do I keep them? Sure, great, it's digital, but all of them are sitting on my email, right? Now, what do I do with this? I go to the store, should I keep showing them one by one? So that again, there was actually a lot of demand in the market for us to create a merchant-specific wallets, where consumers can actually store each of these gift cards into those wallets and can spend them at the store as a single wallet, kitty, as it being necessary to worry about every single gift card underneath that. So there's a lot of things that have evolved, right? And today we believe many of those, we can bring all the parts to the market, work with you all, and evangelize this category. And the intent here is, you would find here, we have merchants, we have, you know, people who are actually facilitating sales of these gift cards issued by the merchant, all in the same platform, right? And we're looking at it as more like a catalyst in this whole ecosystem, right? To be the technology providers, you'll be the catalyst to make this happen, right? But ultimately, I think it's from next year on, we're hoping that this becomes your forum. You know, it becomes your best practices forum that you can all share how we can actually build this category out. This is a quick AB to just talk of some of the products that over the years, based on our learning that we have been able to create, that we feel could be again very relevant to this market, right? And post that, I leave it open for questions. So share as a formal presentation, I think the final message, I think it's a great opportunity that we're all sitting here. I think collectively we can actually create this whole category around it.
Hello, two questions for you, slightly unrelated. First one is, briefly you touched upon omnichannel wallets,
yeah,
with gift cards. Could you elaborate on that a little bit?
Sure.
Secondly, one of the biggest challenges we face in promoting gift cards to our consumers is misuse. So if we start incentivizing customers to use gift cards, they might just, you know, kind of take it and use it for their own purpose. How do you overcome some of that?
Sure. So let me take the first question that you have. So the omnichannel wallet for us has been, let's take an example of a brick and mortar retail, just to explain the concept, right? Let's take something like a shop store, right? Which is largest department stores in India. So they have, you know, their physical stores, they also have their online stores, right? So the first stage was for us to create a physical card, like I said, which can be, initially the paper vouchers could not be used online. They were able to use it only at their physical stores. They didn't have any mechanism to allow an instrument like a gift voucher usable online, right? That was the starting point, right? So we converted them into our digitally technology-powered gift cards, okay? Which could be used at a physical store and the online store. That was the first stage, right? Then he said, you know what, physical has its own challenges, so we got them to the digital card, which is still a single instrument which can be used at physical stores as well as online store. And the fact that the entire backend is managed by us, the backend of a store value agent is like your debit card system. It's like an account management system, right? So every single transaction, be it at a physical store or online, hits our server. So it's like you have an account from where the balance is getting deducted. So that's the way a typical gift card system works. So with this, we could actually get the same card to be used at the physical and online store. It kind of, and then when they brought in their mobile app, the same thing was enabled, right? Now, this is all working fine. Now, we have scenarios where when you start distributing gift cards, there are many situations where you distribute fixed denomination gift cards, for example, right? Let's say I have, $200 worth reward points with Citibank. Now, I want to burn that. Now, many of the people who manage, say, catalogs, they used to have fixed denominations in it, right? So you would have fixed denominations, say, $25, for example. So people used to end up getting 8 digital gift cards. So how do you enable them to use it, right? And second, Shopper Stop began as an online store, offline. They had the store credits, they had this, returns that were coming in online, right? Now, how do they manage all these things, right? That's where we kind of brought in an omnichannel wallet today. So every consumer is identified. I mean, you can design the mechanism to identify, but in the case of Shopper Stop, they identify them to say mobile number. So every one of these cards keep getting added to their quote-unquote the wallet. So now you have maybe 5 gift cards that you received by burning your reward points. Maybe somebody might have gifted you a gift card that is also sitting into that. It could be a physical card which you digitized and added into it, right? It could be a cashback given by Shopper Stop which has gone into it, right? Now, as a consumer, you don't have to worry about each individual instrument. Now, here's a kitty that you have which has got, let's say, this 15, 20 gift cards, right? Now, I go online, I log in, the moment I log in, it is already linked to this wallet. When I go to check out, I just say I'm burning from this quote-unquote gift card wallet. And of course, the backend technology that we provide to them, it automatically, figures out. You can set precedence to say, first I will burn from, let's say, my promotions kitty. Maybe after that I'll burn from my refunds. Maybe after that I'll burn from my gift cards. I mean, you can actually define the precedence, right? Based on the precedence, underneath you can look at validity and stuff like that and, automatically burn it, right? Now you come to the store, present your mobile number again to the cashier. And in our system, they're pretty much integrated with the billing applications of the merchants. So you do the bill, you do a tender as, let's say, gift card wallet, it asks you for a mobile number, put the mobile number, do the OTP, you're done, behind the scenes with your money. So now the whole idea here is, when now the merchant wants to, let's say, give out a promotion campaign, he already has linked the mobile number to the wallet, he does it from behind the scene. And immediately the consumer is notified saying, hey, you're being given this 200 rupees, come and shop. Right? Any behavior, you go spend, you want to run a campaign saying you spend 2,000 rupees, you get a benefit. It again gets pushed to their wallet. So the whole process now is seamless. Now, traditionally, otherwise gift cards, many times the merchant will not even know who the holder of the gift card is. Who is the beneficiary? You wouldn't know. It is just a bare instrument. Whereas with this, what has happened, he is able to link the gift card beneficiary to a wallet account and now is able to engage much better with the consumer. Use the same mechanism to reward him, to drive cashbacks, promotions, pretty much everything happens to that, right? That's how they feel is hugely powerful, and the experience for the consumer is seamless. Be it at the physical store or be it online, the experience is seamless. He's working out of the same kit, right? Your second question, it's a very valid question, I would say there's an easy way to solve it, right? One of the things many of the merchants in India are not comfortable doing is discounting a gift card in any, consumer check. See, they find discounting it in the B2B because it's a B2B purchase, corporate purchasing and giving it to the employees and stuff. In general, they're very wary of discounting it in the online channels. Now, the reason being, many of them could become into self-use, right? Having said that, there are times when you want people to experience, trial, check out these gift cards, try how it works, they want them to know about it, right? These are the times when actually they run promotions, where they want them to, get used to the concept. Second, Some of them, you know, it's also philosophy. Some of them view it as, you know, I'm getting discounts. Okay, I want to drive footfall. I know when they come into the store, I'm giving them 5% off on, let's say, a $25 gift card. But when they come to the store, they want to spend $100. I don't mind giving it because it is driving footfall to the store, right? So they are happy doing that. Okay, so it is finally up to the marketing. You know, what does he want to achieve, right? If you want drive footfall, they don't mind. But then what they do is they don't keep it any denomination. They would typically say, 10% off on a 5 rupee gift card. You know, when they walk in, they want to spend maybe 3,000, 4,000 rupees, right? So that's the way they do that, right? Or they will restrict it to saying only one per person. You can't take more than one, right? So whenever there are such campaigns which could technically be used for self-use or potential for abuse, there are a lot of conditions that are put on it. Okay, so that it doesn't go out of control, and the objective is clear, saying, yeah, I know I'm spending this, but this is how I'm going to gain. And more they go through these gift cards and do this, we are able to give them back insights, saying how many people actually used it, what was the actual spend, you know, the actual bill value, what we call as uplift. We're able to say how successful each one of this campaign has been for them, and that they used to actually change the next campaign. We also give them which channel worked well. For example, Shoppers Stop gift card may be sold at Amazon, at the Paytm, at Samsung Pay, Phone Pay, Snapdeal, all these places, right? We run the same campaign at all these places. Now, we can actually tell them which channel worked better. So they can fine tune that, right? So, yes, it is something you have to do it very carefully because otherwise you're discounting cash. But as long as you do it with a clear objective, as long as you have the right controls in place, it's actually worked nicely as a tool.